My name is Neil Pittori. This is ESE 471. In this segment, we're going to answer the question, how do we convey digital information with an orthonormal basis? First of all, we're going to have to define an orthonormal basis. We talked about orthogonality, but here I'm going to define orthonormal and basis at the same time. A set of waveforms phi 0, V1, V2, all the way to Vk minus 1 form an orthonormal basis if every pair is orthogonal. That is, I can take any two out of those k waveforms and they're orthogonal. And each has unit energy. That is, the energy in the signal. That is the integral over all time of the squared magnitude of the waveform is 1, no matter what k is. This is the definition of an orthonormal basis. It takes the definition of orthogonal, which we talked about, and it extends it to a whole set of capital K different waveforms. Because they're waveforms, I already know that they're finite energy, but more than finite energy, I'm saying that orthonormal, the normal part, meaning that we've normalized everything to unit energy. At each symbol period, we're going to send a particular linear combination of these capital K waveforms. And the particular K waveforms and the list of the capital M different possibilities is what we're going to call our digital modulation. It's something that the transmitter and receiver agree upon ahead of time. And each of these capital M different possibilities, we're going to call a symbol, and we're going to assign a string of bits to it. And when the transmitter sees what string of bits it needs to send, it looks up the symbol that is the one of the capital M possibilities that corresponds to that string of bits, and then it sends that symbol. Okay, it sends it next. So I've defined symbols here as the linear combination of the K orthogonal waveforms. Okay, and we're going to write the mth symbol, okay, s sub m of t. And the first, when we write a linear combination, we're writing constants multiplied by our waveforms. So we take our constant, we're going to call it a, and because it's for the first phi, we're going to multiply it by phi zero of t. Because it's the mth symbol and the zeroth waveform, we're going to write this as a sub m comma zero, and it's multiplied by that waveform plus another constant multiplied by phi 1 of t, and because again it's the mth symbol and the waveform number 1, we're going to write it like that. And we're going to do this for every waveform up to the k minus 1 amplitude and waveform. And this is just one possibility. M could be anywhere from 0 to capital M minus 1. Rather than writing out this long expression for each symbol's function, what we're going to do is we're going to write it in a more convenient notation. So for example, we're going to write the vector SM. Now, this is just a convenient way to store all of the amplitudes about the mth symbol. So I'm going to write it as AM comma 0, AM comma 1, dot, 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 down to the capital K minus 1 amplitude. And I'm going to put this in a vector. This is the mth vector. I'm going to have S sub 0. I'm going to have S sub 1 all the way up to S sub m minus 1. And these capital M vectors are just the lists of the amplitudes that we're going to use. But in addition to being lists, they're also vectors. So I can plot them as if I'm plotting a vector in a vector space. So let's give an example, because with all these m's and k's and s's, this is kind of a little abstract. So last time we had this example that we had two different waveforms. Those were a cosine at 2 pi t. Here I'm going to divide t by the symbol period because I'm going to try to make it a little bit more realistic. This is going to be what we're going to call phi 0. And our phi 1 was a cosine at 4 pi, twice the frequency. We showed last time graphically that these are orthogonal. You could plug it into the formula for orthogonality and prove that as well. I'm going to have to say that these are for 0 to t sub s so that they are waveforms. They don't have infinite energy, and implicitly I'm saying 0 otherwise. I have not shown that these are unit energy, and in fact, they're not. So what I'm actually going to have to do here is I'm going to have to go back and fix the amplitude of these waveforms so that they have unit energy. So let me do that. I'm going to calculate the energy in the signal, which is, as we said, phi 0 of t squared dt. I'll start with the first one, of course. And because they're 0 except for between 0 and t sub s, I can change my limits. I've got a cosine squared 2 pi t divided by t sub s dt. I'm going to replace the cosine squared with a trig rule that is 1 half 1 plus cosine of twice the what's in the parentheses there. Do the integral. So I'm going to have the 1 is going to turn into a t plus cosine is going to turn into a sine. And then on the bottom is going to be a t sub s divided by 4 pi. The kind of the between 0 and t sub s. I'm going to get 1 half. And this t is going to be t sub s minus 0 for that term, and then I'm going to add in the difference between t being t sub s and 0 in the second term, which is going to be sine of 4 pi minus sine of 0. This whole term is going to go to 0. And I'm going to have t sub s over 2 as the energy. In order to make this waveform be an orthonormal basis, I'm going to need to write it as follows. I'm going to need to take this inverse of my unit of my waveform energy here and put it out front. So I've got a square root of 2 divided by t sub s cosine of 2 pi t divided by t sub s between 0 and t sub s, and then write my other orthogonal waveform in the same way. You can see here that it doesn't really matter if I put a 4 pi here, I'd still get the same exact energy out of the signal. So I'd have a 2 over t sub s here cosine of 4 pi t divided by t sub s between 0 and t sub s. Okay, so let's start the problem over again, but use these as our orthonormal basis. I also said that we need linear combinations of these orthonormal basis functions, so we're going to have a list. Okay, and these lists are going to be the linear combinations of these, and I'm going to write them as vectors, S0, and let's say we're going to have, we have k equals 2, we're going to list m equals 4 possibilities. And I'm going to just make them easier by making them plus 1 and plus 1 for the first one. I'm going to say the next symbol is going to be a plus 1 and a minus 1. And then S2, 2 minus 1s. And then S3, the last possibility, 1, minus 1, and plus 1. Okay, so these four vectors, you can see that, for example, S0 of t is going to be 1 times this orthonormal basis function, 2 divided by t sub s, cosine of 2 pi t divided by t sub s, plus another 1 times, I gotta remember to put the 2 over t sub s out front. Okay, so S1 would be similar, except that the second waveform would have a minus 1 instead of a plus 1 multiplying it. Okay, so you can see how this would go all the way up to S3. But what I wanted to talk about was that we're gonna have m equals 4 different possibilities on our list of possible symbols. We could then graph them. So here I'm plotting the cosine of 2 pi t sub s, and I'm plotting the cosine of 4 pi t divided by t sub s, and I'm plotting these four possible linear combinations on the right. On the right hand side, you can see that S0, the one that I drew out or wrote out here, although I did not include the square root of 2 divided by t sub s on my labels here, this is normalized by the square root of 2 over t sub s, if you will. This function in blue is S0 of t, the one in black is S3 of t, the one in red is S1 of t, and the green one is S2 of t. You can see what the transmitter would send in this example of a m equals 4, k equals 2 modulation system. I should say also that we would assign particular bit strings to each of these. In S0, we'd say maybe it carries bit 0, this next one would carry bit 01, this one maybe would carry 11, and then the last one, S3, would carry 10. Okay, and when the transmitter wants to send a 01, it would look up S1 of t and send that. When it wants to send a 10, it would send S3, for example. And so you'd see this sequence, one after the other, of these symbols that exist between, in this plot, between 0 and t sub s, but they would follow each other, and then the next one would be between t sub s and 2 t sub s, and so on, until all of the data was sent. Again, the point of this is to understand how we convey digital information with an orthonormal basis.